In this video, we'll create a spreadsheet simulation for the sum of two dice. So the first thing we want to do is put in cell A4 here the probability that we get the face equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6 for one particular die. So of course, on a fair die, that's just simply equal to 1 over 6. And if we divide, if we copy this formula down with the same value, then what we want to do is just check to make sure that those possible probabilities, when we add them up, they should sum to 1. So of course they do. Each one of them is 1 over 6. Now what we want to do is we need to calculate the probability that the face is less than I. In other words, we're going to get the cumulative distribution here. So starting with the probability that the face is going to come up less than 1, of course that probability is 0. Now the cumulative probability for the probability that the face is going to be less than 2, that's just the probability that the face is equal to 1. So in that case we can reference cell A4. And in the next case we're going to need to add together the probability that the face is equal to either 1 or 2. So in this case, what we can do is use a formula that we'll be able to copy down. We can make this equal to B5 plus A5. Now we can copy this formula down. And we have the cumulative distribution function for this. This is going to be very important information that we're going to use to simulate each toss. Now, the key function that we can use to create this simulation is the rand function to get a random number between 0 and 1. And then we'll also use that together with the vlookup function to determine which value the toss is going to be for each die, so whether it be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. So to do that, we're going to need to use the VLOOKUP function. So we're going to put that here. And the value that we're going to be looking for is the random number. And then what we're going to do is specify this table array that we've just created. And since each of those is a number between 0 and 1, we're going to figure out which one it's closest to. And that's going to help us determine whether we're going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. So now, let's make this range an absolute reference. That way we can use the same formula by copying it to another cell and keeping exactly the same thing. And then the column index that we're going to do, now the match is going to be the lookup on the first column, but which column do we want to return? Well, we want to return the value from the second column, which is going to return the value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. So we'll put a column 2 here. And then by default, the VLOOKUP formula does true by default, means an approximate match. If you put false, then it will only find a exact match. And in this case, with the simulation, we actually want the value true, or we can leave it blank and have the default, because we do want to get the number that comes closest to that point on the cumulative distribution function. Okay, so we can just put this formula just like this, or as I mentioned, if you prefer, you can also put comma true. True is the default, so either way will work. So now if we click enter, this will give us a simulation for that die. Now under formulas, I've set the calculation options. Currently it's to automatic, but if I set this to manual, then it'll allow me to control when I can recalculate the cells. So now if I click calculate now, we'll see that value in cell F4 changed. In this case, it changed to 6. If I click again, 4, and it's going to be 4 again, 6, and different values that might come up. Now what I want, of course, is to do that also for the second die, because I have two dice, and if I calculate, see, I'll get different values. Now I want to do this, let's say I wanted to do the simulation actually maybe 1,000 times. All I need to do is copy those formulas down. Now it's giving the same values because I haven't recalculated the cells, but as soon as I hit calculate now, we see a number of different values all between 1 and 6 that come up with all of these simulated rolls of the two dice. So now what I want to know is what's the sum of the two dice. All I need to do is add these two numbers together. And then if we copy that formula down and then recalculate the cells, we'll get different sum of the two dice from each toss that we're simulating. So now if I want to figure out what is the average sum that I get, all I need to do is use the average formula. And we'll select the whole range for all the times I've simulated. In this case, I think I simulated 1,000 times, so it's going to go all the way to cell 1003, H1003. And that'll give me the average of all of those simulations. Now, if I want to figure out what's the minimum, well, we expect this to be 2, because the lowest we can get on die 1 and die 2 is 1, and we add those together as 2, so we do expect that this is going to be 2, but if we didn't have very many runs of the simulation, maybe 50 or less, we might not get 2. And then for the maximum, we expect to have 12, of course, so 6 is the maximum we can have on each die, so if we do this with a maximum formula, with the same range, we should get 12 as the maximum, as we expect. Okay, and we just amount, if we could click recalculate now, we see some differences on the average sum, but we are always getting the same minimum and same maximum. Well, there it is, there's our simulation of the two dice.